learning from our past can pave the way forward. And that inspiration for us from our past has led us to develop an area in Guelph known as the Guelph Innovation District. And this district in Guelph, it's got a long history. I have to go back about 100 years to 1910, very specifically. And the province were looking to reform how they dealt with reformatories in Ontario. And there's about 1,000 acres, there still is 1,000 acres of property here in Guelph that was out in the boonies, quite frankly, then, and we've built up and out to this location now. So they wanted to try something new in 1910, a live, play, and work sort of approach. They were able to build facilities, they grew some crops and farmed the land, they had their own livestock, they built slaughterhouses for that livestock. They built manufacturing plants, and of course, they built some health facilities, healthcare facilities, and education facilities. Layered on top of that was a network, a road network, that connected the entire 1,000 acres to each other, but just as importantly, it connected to them to the town of Guelph at the time. And that component allowed them to take their goods into market. But also surprising for us, there was a district energy system in 1910, if you can believe that. So that was a gift that keeps on giving for us, and we're very interested in that as we go forward. Who's in favor of complete communities? Right, so of course. We've all been in cities that we've connected with, and that's because they found a way. They found a way to sort of take care of their citizens from 8 to 80, with the demographics, from multi-stock, multi-purpose housing. All of that stuff that resonates with us resonates with you as well. And it's 2018, and we wanted to up our game, so not just live, work, and play, but we wanted to add healthy, prosperous, and sustainable community to our sort of targets as well. And so that we've done. Being creatures of the province, of course, here in Ontario, we've got our targets from them, and there's 6,500 new folks that will move into this new urban village, compact urban village. And by compact, I don't mean cheek to jowl. I mean it's a walkable, livable community. This is a community that will connect all of our bike paths with our trails to our parks network. It'll be our research park will be connected in the same common space that we have for our residential sector. In fact, our road allowance will likely be our transit way and our cycling way. So this is sort of a first for Guelph that we see. This is an opportunity to navigate this development area without the use of a car. And that's why we're able to sort of put our tagline on that. We think this should be a neutral, carbon neutral step forward for Guelph, and that'll be a first for us. So that's clearly a target for us, and that renewable piece isn't a big part of it. So whether it's geothermal or solar thermal or solar panels, we're spending a lot of time sort of on the next step for that industry as well. And of course, the district energy piece will be a big part of that. We want to take advantage of that. We believe there's a giant business case there for that with the loads from the residential sector, especially in the evening hours, but also from the business sector as well during the day. And that's the benefit of implementing that district energy system. So now's an opportunity to do that. And we think there's actually some of the piping that we can still take advantage of that were in the ground from 1910, believe it or not. So that's the other piece from that as well. And then also our leap is to, we'll have a research park and there'll be 6,000 new jobs created in this area. Guelph is situated right on our innovation corridor between Kitchener-Waterloo and Toronto. We're kitty corner with the University of Guelph, and this is right in their wheelhouse. So who better than them to invest in this park? We think that they'll be an investor so that they can commercialize anything that comes out of that business park itself. We've got big challenges in front of us. This is complex planning work. We want adaptive reuse for the correction facilities or cultural heritage pieces to this or natural heritage pieces. And with that challenge has to become the right partners, and we've found them. So Infrastructure Ontario, we want to buy it from them. The next step for us is finding the right investor. We're now going to start a GID office, or a Guelph Innovation District office, that will be staffed and budgeted accordingly, building on our past, leading to our future as we plan it now. So thank you very much.